centered good?
Yep. Nope.
Are you sure? Can you even see the screen?
Yep. I don't want to make sure.
Oh, you're touching it.
I'm touching you to make sure the focus is on you.
Alright.
Alright, go.
I don't remember what I said last time.
Say something original.
Hi guys, welcome to MACNA 2015.
MACNA is the Marine Aquarium Conference of North America. It takes place every year. This year it landed in D.C. And the first thing you'll notice when you come in the doors is it's promoting next year's event, which is always highly anticipated as big news. Next year it's in San Diego, and the San Diego Club is hosting it. So, now let's go inside and check out what's going on. This is Julian Sprung on the left speaking with the club president, talking about his experience with this year's MACNA and how well it went. Being able to talk with vendors about their own products is the best way to be educated on how to take care of your aquarium. Because we go out and we buy these beautiful fish, these beautiful corals, we put them in our aquariums, we buy some bottles because the fish store or some ad we saw in a magazine or online business promoted it, and then what do we do with it? Sometimes we don't know. Here's Ecotech showing off their brand new Vectra pump. You can see it in the sump, it's leaning a little bit, but that's okay. I actually hung out in the booth for a while because I'm getting one of those pumps myself, and it should be shipping out this week. Here's the smaller one, and then the L1 on the right is mine. Also, MaxSpec has a new type of light that came out that kind of reminds me of the Enterprise. It's pretty cool looking. Here's the tank lit up with them. And it has a cooling fan on the top that was kind of at a different angle. And then it was vented through the sides, so it's definitely not going to overheat. Coral View has all kinds of products there, and they were showing off some of their new goodies. But this was neat. This sofa was at MACNA in 2010, and there we had autographed it. It was all full of graffiti from all the different speakers and vendors, and we had fun filling it up with our art. Jessie had a hand in several of these herself. So I was happy to sit down on it for a moment and remember those memories from 5 years ago. One of my favorite parts of visiting MACNA is seeing what new gear has come to market. And as you walk from booth to booth, you try to see what's new, what's exciting. How have they changed the design? Here's a brand new return pump from the Apex people at Neptune Systems. And it works in conjunction with float switches and controls flow rates. And there's even a small flow meter that can control exactly how much water comes out of the pipe, specifically by computer control. I love seeing all my different friends from all these different companies in their booths, smiling, excited, and the excitement lasts all 3 days. Sure, it's exhausting because we are on the clock, around the clock, but look at what we get to see. It's awesome. Here's a beautiful tank set up by Pro Aquatics. It's been at MACNA for the last few years, and you get to see these look-down fish working in a circle around this tank. I kind of would like some of these look-down fish, but I heard they get really big. I've seen them when they're large. And apparently they're rather carnivorous, and they may devour some of my other fish. So I've resisted the urge, and I stick to small, friendly fish that I know are reef safe. You'll see seahorses and jellyfish. Here's the Senai controller. These guys have asked me to go ahead and check out their gear, and they're going to send me one to test out so I can do a product review for you guys on YouTube. Also, there's aquacultured fish, like this one booth had, where they've raised them from small fry so they can be sold, and they're not taken from the ocean. Rod's Food, that's my favorite. I use it every single day. If you don't want to miss the raffles happening in all the different booths, how about taking your phone out of your pocket and setting alarms to remind you for every prize you're trying to win? Let's walk around a little bit and kind of give you a bird's eye view of what it looks like when you're attending MACNA. The booths go everywhere. There was rows and rows in rooms and rooms of vendors. Probably 145 vendors were on display this year, maybe even more. That gives you time to see about 35 a day. You'll be busy all 3 days. This booth has some reef jewelry. There's also educational booths. There's booths about the environment to protect our oceans. I saw booths about raising fish fry, specifically to get involved in the breeding aspect. And of course, there's just the fun things that you want for your aquarium or the things you might have thought about buying and never have until now. Here's a whole opportunity to get all kinds of reef clothing while you're buying some corals, maybe even a saw. We're coming up on a big raffle happening right now, so let's just see what it looks like for a second. Everyone's all gathered around, they're trying to win items from the Reef to Reef booth, and I'm just trying to get through this crowd. Now, don't worry. It's not like this the entire time. There's definitely wide open areas to walk around. This is just an exciting moment when a bunch of people gather together to see if they won. There's also live rock on display. Some is being made by man, others are being aquacultured in the ocean. Karen Talbot does some beautiful paintings of various kinds of fish from the oceans, and they're all scientifically accurate. She makes sure that every bone, every spine, every gill, every fin is exactly the way it's supposed to be in nature. You'll also see new products come to market, like these little tiny airstone pumps that they were selling in bulk, trying to stock up stores. And some frag systems, where you can get your frag plugs decorated in a pretty way. See these awesome skimmers? That one on the left is going to be beta tested by me. It's being shipped to my door, and we'll give it a run for its money. Now, there's plenty of corals on display throughout the building. Lots of good pricing. Some are low, some are higher. It just depends what you see. But for me, it's all about the equipment. It always has been. It always will be. I really enjoy seeing the innovative designs that are made that are both fun, interesting, exciting, and if it'll save me money or make my tank run better, I'm very interested. This next booth is Sustainable Aquatics, and these are the people that I got all my skunk clownfish from that you saw in a previous video with the tube of acrylic where I sent them into the anemone. And I thought, well, I've got to visit this booth for a minute and see the beautiful fishes. It's nice to see that they're selling corals now, too. How do you get all these items home? Some people ask me that. A lot of us put them inside our suitcase, packed up in a soft collapsible cooler in the dead center of the suitcase to get them home intact as quickly as possible. Look at all these tiny clownfish. They're so awesome. Little babies. This breeder booth was explaining how the process works, and they had all their gear set up so we could totally understand it if we wanted to try it ourselves. I asked a few questions, but I still to this day have not tried to raise any tiny fish yet. Imagine that. You start with a couple, and you have 100 extras on your hand. Didn't cost you anything but time, food, salt water, testing. Okay, so there is some effort involved. There are many men and women in this hobby that raise all different types of fish. I believe there's over 125 different saltwater fish being reared at this time. It's pretty impressive, and that number grows every year. I really appreciate how the different vendors set up aquariums filled with coral, livestock, and show their equipment being used. And when I spot something tiny, it catches my eye, and I want to see what's within. And if I looked closely in this tank, I found two tiny harlequin shrimp. They kind of look pink and blue to me, his and hers. And there is a frogfish right there tucked away in next to that rock, blending in beautifully. Here's a small pufferfish, maybe an inch long, inch and a half. Going from room to room, I came across a bunch more vendors. In this section over here, I came across the Carib Sea people. I then found myself into Red Sea, which led to Cobalt, which I sell a lot of these products from my shop. And then it leads over into Tidal Gardens. And Tidal Gardens has a beautiful YouTube channel, if you haven't checked it out yet. They do some incredible macro photography, very smooth, super intense imagery. It's fantastic. And it was nice to meet with Than for a few minutes and talk. Tico Chillers are based out of Dallas, Texas, as far as I know. And a lot of people use them to keep their tanks nice and cool in the event of excess heat. And check out this pump. It's been out for a couple of years now. This is the Abyss pump, and it's made in Germany with a 10-year warranty, and I am so impressed with it. The biggest pump is pretty pricey at $2,500, but you will have that pump for 10 years, so that's only $250 a year. I asked Jeff to turn up the flow on this pump to the maximum, and so that's what he's doing right here. And when it has the head pressure of shooting straight up 45 feet. So it could go in a basement and push up to the second floor, possibly even the third. The Abyss pump is fully programmable. It uses very low wattage to move a lot of water at different flow rates, different pulses. It can do all kinds of neat stuff. It's a big investment. I told him I was using this clip. Clownfish are my favorite, and so every time I see them, I stop to stare. And it was nice to see some mangroves on display. There's the Kessel AP700 that I just reviewed recently. That was on display in several booths here at MACNA this year. Historically at MACNA, one of the other things that's exciting to do is to get involved in the raffle, to try and win some goodies to bring home. I try to always put in tickets for things I can actually take home, things that I need. I don't try to win the grand prize necessarily because what am I going to do with it? I already have a huge tank. Here's Blue Life USA. That's where Safety Stop and Phosphate RX come from that I sell. And I'm really pleased to continue to support that company. MACNA is attended by thousands of people every year. I'd say about 3,000 attend the show. And during that time, they're either in the vendor hall, checking out all the different products for sale, or they're in the speaker rooms, hearing presentations by the 20 plus speakers that are there all 3 days, that start first thing in the morning and run all day long. It's actually kind of hard to choose what you want to do, what's more important to you, which talks do you want to hear, which ones are you willing to skip. But for new people that have never been to MACNA before, they are overwhelmed. They can't believe how much is here at their fingertips and how much they can benefit. Friday evening is the reception, where about 1,500 to 2,000 people show up to have drinks, listen to some live music, visit one another, eat finger foods, catch up, plan out their weekend. That's a lot of fun. And Saturday night is the gala, which is a catered dinner where we're all seated and have a fantastic time hearing who's won what awards, getting a keynote speaker that talks to us about the future of the hobby. Hello. And it's again a chance to sit down, dress up, and enjoy each other's company. Mindstream is a new Kickstarter program with a gizmo that affixes to the glass wall of your tank and measures multiple parameters of your aquarium nonstop, reporting that data to you constantly. Several people are really excited about this right now. The price point's pretty high, and there's a monthly fee for a disc that you have to constantly change out to keep getting that data. So it will be interesting to see where this goes. Shiny new sumps are on display. Shiny new reactors are on display. Everyone's out there with something new to bring to the market, something that you can ask for at your fish store or watch for sale online. The more colorful, the more popular it seems. At next year's MACNA, I'll have a booth myself, and I'll be selling items from Mila's Reef, like I did a few years ago. So I mentioned before about getting your corals home and how that might be complicated. If you're local, it's easy. You throw them in your car in a cooler and you head home. If you're flying home and you might have to deal with TSA, just remember the rule about how much water you're allowed to carry. So what do you think so far? Are you excited? Does this seem like someplace you'd like to be? Then I'd highly recommend that you consider signing up right now to attend MACNA next year in San Diego. It really doesn't matter what city it's in. If it's not in your town, you're going to need to fly there or drive there. You're going to need to rent a hotel. You're going to, you know, it's going to cost you some money. But if you start saving up right now and just commit to going, you'll have a blast with all of us and become part of this big saltwater family. To see people each year and catch up with how they are doing, what's going on with their tanks, or what things they've invented, that's awesome. And I spent some time in the Two Little Fishies booth and found out that there's some new products coming out soon. There's already some new ones now. But there's stuff coming up, and I'm going to be using some of them myself. And knowing what's happening is half the battle, right? Because if you know what's coming out, you can plan accordingly for your reef. Being a past MACNA organizer myself, and being someone that's attended MACNA since 2002, every year I get to compare how this show is going versus the last one. Yeah. And this club did a fantastic job. I saw no negativity, no drama. Everyone had a good time. There was just happy faces everywhere, parents teaching their children about things and getting the next generation ready so that they can have saltwater tanks when they grow up. And then they'll teach their children and so forth. Because all of this beauty that's hiding in our oceans, we can actually enjoy it in our homes, or we can plan on trips to visit it elsewhere. So here's my loot. This is the stuff I brought home. More Predibio, some magnesium, a way to calibrate my refractometer, water testing t-shirts, backpacks, fish samples, sunglasses, but I'm ready for next year already. I love MACNA, and I hope that you'll join us next year. I want to hang out with you, I want to visit with you, and I want to know what you think of it yourself. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe, share, and like it!